Hi, this is Anne from Design Bundles, and today I'm going to show you how to make a spooky witch hat with knockout text in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm here in Adobe Illustrator, and first I'm going to come over here to Create New. I'll come up to the top and choose Print, and then I'll choose Letter, and then come down here to Create. All right, the first thing I want to do is create my witch's hat. So I'm going to hit P on my keyboard, which will bring me to the pen tool, which is right over here. And I'm just going to click one time and then click over here. Make a few different clicks. Now, if you click and drag, you're going to get a smooth point. So if you don't want that, you can just Command Z or Control Z on a PC to back up. Just going to make a few more paths and points. And then we'll get to the brim. Now across here, this part down here, I want it to be smooth. So I'm going to click right here and then drag. And then come back up here to finish the shape. I'm going to use my A tool, which is the direct selection tool, to grab this point and move it up just a little bit. Okay, now we have our hat shape. Now you might have a couple different colors going on. So if you do, just hit D on your keyboard and that'll give you a white fill and a black outline like me. I actually want this to be a black fill and no outline for now. So I'm going to hit Shift X. That's the same as swapping the fill and stroke, it's right here. And then I'll click on the stroke and just choose none right here. Okay, now we've got our hat. Now I'm going to add a band across this part of the hat. So to do that, I'm going to hit M on my keyboard, which is the rectangle tool. And I'm just going to drag it across like this and get it pretty close to those two points, this one and this one over here. That looks pretty good. I'm going to click on my fill and change the color to green. And now I'm going to come up here to Effect, Warp, and Arch. And I've got a negative bend here and a horizontal orientation. So my negative bend is just a little too much, so I'm going to make it a little less. That looks good. And we'll say OK. Now you can see that you've got lines here and then you've got the curved lines underneath the blue lines, if that makes sense. So if we hit Command Y or Control Y on a PC, this still looks like a rectangle. Let's hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. So we need to expand this so it follows that curve. Let's go up to Object and Expand Appearance. And now you can see the paths follow the curve that you can see. So you're basically expanding that warp. Okay, I'm going to hit V on my keyboard to get to my Move tool, and I'm just going to move this up a little bit, right about here. Then I'm going to rotate it by hitting R on my keyboard. I'll just click over here to set the anchor point, and then drag on this side. I'm going to use my arrow keys to move this up a little bit so I can see where my two points in the hat are that I want the band to come to. And then I'll just move it back down and get it pretty close to those two points. Okay, this is looking nice. Now I'm going to select the black hat. I want an outline to come right down here so I can see the hat and you can see the band inside it, kind of. So I'm going to copy this, Command C or Control C. Then I'll click off. And then I'm going to paste in front with Command F or Control F. Okay, now let's change this to a stroke only by swapping the fill and stroke. I'll increase it right up here in the control bar. If you're not seeing this control bar, you can go to Window Control right here. All right, let's go back on that and increase it even more. Okay, I like how that looks. I'm sure you've noticed that we have these two overhanging areas. So to fix that, I'm going to select the green area, hold Shift, and select the black area. And then we're going to get on our Shape Builder tool. And to do that, we'll hit Shift M. Now I can hold Option or Alt and just click on these pieces that I don't want, and it gets rid of them. So really right now we have three pieces, three shapes that we're working with. We've got a shape right here that is just an outline and it's sitting on top. We've got this green band and then we've got the background black shape. All right, now all we have to do is add our text. So I'm going to start typing, and to do that, I'll hit T on my keyboard, which will bring me to this tool, the type tool right over here. I'll click once and I'll type one. I'm going to get back on my selection tool, then grab a corner and hold shift and make it quite a bit bigger. There's a font that I really like for this one. It's called Barn Dance Regular. So it's this one right here, and I'll make it even bigger still. And then pull it up into the top area. Now it's black and it's sitting on black, so we need to change the color of the font. To do that, we'll come over here to color. By the way, if you don't have these palettes open, you can always go to window and find them here. The character palette will be under your type, so all of the type ones are under here. So I'm on my color palette now, and I'm just going to click white. Now I'm going to make another text path, and I'm going to type something right in here. So I'm going to hold option and click and drag this one, or alt on a PC. That'll make a duplicate of whatever you selected. Okay, I'm going to hit T to get back on my text tool and just click in here. Then I'll hit command A or control A to select all of the text. And now I'll type witchy. And then I'll get back on my selection tool. I'll just move it over. And I'm going to use my eyedropper tool to select the black color. So I'll hit I on my keyboard. That'll bring me to the eyedropper tool. And then I can just select the black, and that will change whatever I have selected to the color that I just sampled. Okay, so we've got one witchy, and now we need woman. So I'm going to hold option or alt, click on this one again, and drag it right down here. I'll hit T on my keyboard. And then I'll get into that text field, select all with command A, and type woman. Okay, now let's get back on our selection tool. I'm going to hold shift and select the other two paths. Now I'm going to hit shift command and left caret, that's on your comma key, to make the font smaller. The one right next to it will make it bigger. So shift command, left caret, or shift control, left caret on a PC. Okay, this is looking pretty nice. Now I want to center those. And so to do that, I'll hit Shift Command C. That's Shift Control C on a PC. And that centers the text itself. If we want them centered with each other, we can use the Align palette, which is right down here. And I'll click the Center Align with that. Now I can just click and drag those where they should be. And we can also rotate them a little to match the angle of our hat. Just kind of move them over and up with my arrows and get back on my selection tool, and I'll just click on this one and move it down. All right, let's set this up to use in a cutting machine like Cricut or Cameo. To do that, I'm going to select all, command A or control A, and then I'm going to create outlines on my text. That is shift command O or shift control O on a PC. Next, we need to come up here to expand everything. So object, expand. We will expand the fill and the stroke and say okay. And then it's a good idea to come up here again to object expand and just make sure everything's expanded out. All right, next come down here to the Pathfinder and come to the first one of the Pathfinders called divide. We'll click that. And this will make a separate piece of all of these little pieces that you see. The next step is to select one little piece of the black, for example. We'll do that, and then we'll come up to select same fill color. Now we have all the black things selected. We can come over to the Pathfinder and choose the first shape mode, which is unite. Now I'm going to hide this with command 3 or control 3 on a PC. All right, the next thing we'll do is click on the green, select same fill color, and unite that in the shape mode, and hide that with command 3 or control 3. And then next, with my direct selection tool, I'm just going to draw a big box around everything that's left, and that's the white stuff, and I'm just going to delete that because we want it to actually be knocked out of the black. All right, so we have nothing on our screen anymore, so let's come up to object, Show all. Now we have an SVG file that we can use in a cutting machine. And we could even go one step further and get rid of the green so we only have one black layer. If we look in our layers right now, you'll see the black, all the black things, and then you'll see the green right down here. Now we could go one step further and just get rid of this green layer. And now we have just a one layer black design. So if we want to save this as an SVG file, we can come up here to File, Save As, and then come down here and choose SVG at the very bottom. We'll save that. And I like to choose older files here because they work with older systems. So if somebody doesn't have the latest and greatest software, this SVG will still work for them. All right, so we'll say okay. And now you can just load it into your cutting machine and cut it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.